Now we learn about pie chart. So what is pie chart? A pie chart is also known as circle chart. So this chart divides the circular statistical graphics into sectors or slices in order to illustrate the numerical values. Each sector of pie chart denotes a proportional part of the whole circle. To find out the composition of something, pie chart works the best at that time. So at most cases, pie chart replaces some other graphs like bar graph, line plots, histogram, etc. So that means using the pie chart, we can know the relative proportion of slices. Okay. So let's try one example in our studio. So for this, to draw the pie chart, we need to have the data of slices. Okay. So let's use the, let's give the variable name slices. Slices is equal to, we can give any value. Okay. Let's say 15, 20, 14, 35, 8. So these are some data of slices. So using this data, I am interested to know the relative proportion. Okay. So this data corresponding to some categorical variable name. So for that, let's give the name of each slices. Okay. So let's say that my first value indicates US. This is for example. Okay. Second value represents the data of India. Next value indicates the data of Bangladesh. Okay. Third value indicates the data of Australia. Okay, and last value indicates the data of UK. Okay, so what I did, so these are my slices, so 5 slices I have, and these slices are corresponding to these names. Okay, now I am interested to draw one pie chart. So for that I need to use pie function. And what is the syntax of this pi function? So for that I need to use the function name, that is pi. After that I need to give the slices data. So for my case it is slices. Okay. Then I need to add labels. Labels of each slice of this pi chart. Okay. So in this case it is name. Okay. Then I need to give the figure name. So for that I need to use main parameter. So let's say the name of this figure is simple pie chart. So that's it. So let's execute this code. So these are the data of slices. So this is the labels of the pie chart. And let's execute this one. So it comes some error. So it is names, not name. Okay. So you can see the my pie chart is appeared here, and it shows total 5 slices. Okay. So you can see here the percentage, that is the relative proportion, is not mentioned in this pie chart. Now I am interested to add the percentage to this existing pie chart. For that I need to calculate the percentage, relative percentage of each pie chart. Okay, so for this I need to calculate percentage. Short form is PCT is equal to, I am using this formula, slices divided by sum of slices into 100. So what I did, I have just converted converted these slices into percentage form. Okay, so I will use round function. So round function to make the value as a round. Okay, now it's done. Let's execute this code. Okay, I can see here what is my percentage. Is it? So my percentage is 60, 22, 15, 38, and 9. Now I am going to add this percentage to this existing pie chart. For that, this labels parameter. Okay, so this labels parameter needs to be modified. So for that, let's write new labels is equal to, so in new labels what I will do, I will add these names and percentages together. So for that I need to use paste function. After that I will give the names, okay, comma, then it will be separated by hyphen. Okay, then I will add percentage value, then it will show percentage symbol. Okay, then I need to use the separator parameter as line. Okay, so this is my new labels. So let's execute this one. So it is successfully executed. You can check here what is your new labels. So my new labels is US hyphen 16%, India hyphen 22%, Bangladesh hyphen 15%, Australia hyphen 38%, and UK is 9%. So this is my new label. I am going to add here in this existing pie chart. So here this parameter I need to replace. So it will be replaced by new_labels. Okay. So let's execute this function. So you can see here the labels of this pie chart, it's already modified by percentage. Here country name as well as percentage both appeared. Okay. So now another thing I am interested to do, to use one parameter color to this pie. Okay, so here I will use col is equal to rainbow. So this is one graphics function, rainbow. Here I will use 5 colors of rainbow. So let's execute this one. You can see the color of this pie chart, it is changed. Okay, so this is 2D pie chart. If I am interested to use 3D pie chart, so for that I need to import one library, that is library. I need to import one library. The library name is plot_rex. Okay, so if you are first user of this library, so it is not pre-installed in your RStudio. So for that you need to install this library in your RStudio. For this the command is, you need to write install.packages. After that, within this quotation you need to write plot_rex. Okay, so let me show you here. Okay, so the command is install packages. So in this command you need to write plot_rex. After that you need to press enter. Okay, so it will install your packages. Okay, you can see this plot_rex is successfully installed. So let's use this function. So I have successfully imported plot_rex library in my RStudio. Now I will use all the data, the change in the function. So for that 3D pie chart, I need to use pie 3D function. Okay, so in pie 3D function I need to give all the parameters what is mentioned earlier. Okay, let me paste here. Okay, and one additional parameter I will add, that is explode. So its value I will give 0.0. So let's execute this line. So after executing this line, my pie chart will become 3D. So you can see it appears 3D pie chart. Okay. So what if I change export function? You can see I have changed the value 0.5. Let's run again. So you can see all the slices is separated. Okay, so if you change this explode function, all the slice will be separated, and if we put it is a 0, then it will be your whole circle. Okay, so this is the process of pie chart. Okay, so after drawing your after plotting your pie chart, you can simply save the figure by using png function that is already showed in my last video. Thank you.